Let's talk about the weather. In our neck of the woods, wind finally died down today. Yes. We got that going for it.
Way 31 Chief Meteorologist Kate McKenna is tracking the rain, which we can hear outside of our studios right now, and potential for flood threats for some areas.
Yeah, we didn't really get much of a chance to dry out today. We had all of the rain from yesterday, then a little bit of a break this morning, and now this is the current view on the Way 31 Storm Tracker Early Warning Radar Network. Slowly but surely, the little gap here that we've still got over northeast Alabama is starting to fill in with steady and at times heavy rain. I want you to look closely here, and you'll see some pockets of heavier rain and a couple of lightning strikes showing up there in Winston County. So that's what I'm tracking for you. This little embedded area of thunderstorms tracking towards the northeast is going to be in Hartsell at 506, Fairview 510, Priceville 515, Decatur 525, eventually up into Huntsville by 543. So no, don't be surprised if you hear some rumbles of thunder, but just know there's no outlined risk for severe weather today. But the flooding threat is there, especially with that saturated ground and especially with hours to go with all of this heavy rain continuing to move through. Now, temperatures affected by the rain a little bit. Where that rain has been a little bit heavier, temperatures are dropping pretty quickly again. It's 45 in Athens, 46 in Decatur, and it's still chilly farther towards the east, 48 currently in Fort Payne, 46 in Gunnersville. So as we go through this evening, temperatures don't change very much. It's a 100% chance for rain all through 10 o'clock and even past 10 through early tomorrow morning. You'll see what I mean here as we go through the rest of tonight. We'll stop this at 7 o'clock. Round after round of heavy rain, little bits of a lull here and there between the heavier rain, but generally speaking, it's not letting up anytime soon. Give it some time though, and finally after midnight, still seeing heavy rain, but there it goes off to the east, mainly past between about 3 and 4 o'clock tomorrow morning is when that rain finally starts to shift farther toward the east. We're left with a lingering shower, possible early Wednesday. Aside from that, it's a lot of cloud cover. Rainfall totals here as we go through tonight into early tomorrow morning, between 1 to 2 inches, but locally higher amounts here within these thunderstorms, especially storms that are moving over the same locations. We could be getting 2 to even possibly 3 inches of rain in isolated areas. So just kind of keep that in mind here. Now we're fast forwarding to what looks like a quiet picture Friday morning, 7 a.m. It's not staying that way though. We'll have clouds start to move in, a couple of showers, but really the main event is late Friday night, early Saturday morning. Main event being moisture coming in from the south, cold air coming in from the northwest, and bam, that's our next chance for snow. Yeah, we're talking snow in March. It's not impossible. We know that based on 93, right? But by midnight, notice how that changeover takes place, and we've got snow in the forecast through early Saturday morning. But the ground temperatures are very warm with the kind of weather that we have been seeing. So snowfall rates can overcome that temporarily once the snow stops. Then it's going to start melting. At this point, I would not put my money on anything more than about an inch of accumulation here, especially closer to the Tennessee-Alabama state line. Just know that that number will likely change as we continue to fine tune that forecast for you, but it is something that we're looking at as an expectation now, Friday night into early Saturday morning. Something else that we were expecting and maybe dreading a little bit, the temperatures, 68 on Friday down to 25 Saturday morning, 22 Sunday morning. And yeah, we're also springing forward Saturday night into very early Sunday. We'll be right back.